Good morning, students. So this is physics, chapter number 4, lecture number 2. In this lecture, we'll be studying about Ampere's law and its applications. Before starting Ampere's law, one application of Biot-Siebert's law was left. So we will be doing that first. Okay. So that is magnetic field on the axis of a current carrying coil. So here we have a coil which carries a current in anti-clockwise direction. We want to calculate magnetic field at point P, which is at a distance x from its center. Let us say A is the radius of this coil and let us suppose we choose an element dl here. So as you know, the direction of dl is in the same direction of current. So dl will be also in this direction, and the distance between dl and the point we want to calculate the magnetic field is r. So this is r. Okay, so to exactly understand this, look here. So to understand it, look here. This coil is placed like this. Okay. So now to calculate, now current is flowing in anti-clockwise direction. So this arrow is showing you the direction of current. Okay. So now as you know, the direction of current and dl is same. So for this, the direction of dl is this. Okay. Because the current is flowing like this. So direction of dl will be downwards. Okay. So now this is r. So similarly here, R will be drawn like this from the point P, and it is pointing towards P. Okay, so this is dl, this is R. Now how to calculate direction of magnetic field? Again by using right hand thumb rule. Okay, so put your fingers in the direction of L and curl towards R. So my thumb is going upwards, but remember that B should be perpendicular to dl as well as R. Okay, so to draw a perpendicular, if I draw this line, this will not be perpendicular to dl. So I am drawing this so that it can be perpendicular to r as well. Okay, so remember db is upward, but it is perpendicular to r as well as dl. Okay, so now what will be the angle between dl and r? Now look here, this is dl and this is r. What is the angle between them? Now here is a very, there is always a confusion in this. If I am doing this, the angle is changing, but this angle is changing with this a. Okay, but the angle between dl and r is always 90 degree. This angle is always 90 degree. Only the angle which is changing is with this line, not with this line. This and this are always at 90 degree. Okay, so here angle between dl and r will always be 90 degrees. Okay, so now I hope it is clear what will be the direction of dl, what is the direction of r, and what is the direction of db. Okay, and the angle between dl and r is 90 degrees. Okay, so now if we apply the Biot-Siebert law, it will be equal to db is equal to mu naught upon 4 pi idl sin theta upon r square. So theta is 90 degree between dl and r. So if theta is 90, we will get db is equal to mu naught upon 4 pi idl upon r square. Okay, so now one more thing, we are considering this angle to be phi. Okay, so if this is phi, this will be 90 minus phi, because this is 90, this will be, so this will be 90 minus phi. Okay, if this is 90 minus phi and this is 90, we are again left with phi here. Okay, so we can resolve db. So here db cos phi, and this side db sin phi will come. Okay, so now if you choose a similar element here, for that magnetic field will point in this direction. Db cos phi will come in this direction. Db sin phi will come in this direction. So these two components will cancel out, so only we will be left with db sin phi in this direction. Okay, so if we want to calculate total magnetic field, we will integrate this component db sin phi only, because db cos phi will be cancelled out. Okay, so now to calculate total magnetic field, we will integrate db sin phi. Db, as we have calculated it, it is mu naught upon 4 pi I dl upon r square. So mu naught upon 4 pi I upon r square, integration of dl will come inside. Now to calculate sin phi, look in this diagram. So sin phi is perpendicular upon hypotenuse. So perpendicular is A, hypotenuse is R. So sin phi will be A by R. Okay, so putting the value of sin phi as A by R. Now integration of dl. Integration of dl will done for the loop, and we have chosen the radius of loop to be a, so the integration of dl will be 2 pi a, that is circumference of the loop, that is 2 pi a. Okay, so to put the value of r here, again look in the diagram, this is a, this is x. So using Pythagoras theorem, we can say r will be equal to under root of a square plus x square. Okay, so r is under root of a square plus x square. R cube will be equal to a square plus x square to the power 3 by 2. So this is the value of magnetic field, and if we say there are n turns, then this will be just multiplied by n. So mu naught upon 4 pi 2 n pi Ia square in upon a square plus x square to the power 3 by 2 is the value of magnetic field, and as it this is in the direction of dB sine phi, so we can say it is towards right side or away from the coil. Okay, so now we'll be discussing some cases. So for that, again look at the diagram. So again look at this diagram. First is if x is 0. So if x is 0, that means this point is lying at this point only. That means the formula should come of that which we calculated for a coil when the point was at center. Okay, so putting x equal to 0 in this, you will get a square to the power 3 by 2. 2 will cancel out, so we will get only a cube, and a cube will again get cancelled out by a square. Okay, so we'll get mu naught upon 4 pi I by, just put x equal to 0 and solve it, you will get this thing. Okay, so this is same as we calculated for the point which was at center of the coil. So we can see our formula is correct. So if second thing we choose as x is very very greater than a. If x is very very greater than a, we can just neglect a here from here. A square from here, so neglect it, you will get this value mu naught upon 4 pi 2 n pi I a square x cube. Okay, so now look here carefully. If the radius of the loop is a, pi a square is the area of loop. So area of loop is pi a square. Okay, now as you know, dipole moment, electric dipole moment was defined as Q into 2A, that is charge into distance. Similarly, we define magnetic moment. Magnetic moment is defined as current into area. N is for the number of turns. Okay. So as electric dipole moment is charge into distance, similarly magnetic dipole moment is current into area. So current is I and area is pi a square. So we can say magnetic moment, and we denote it by capital M. So we can say it will be equal to ni pi a square. So C ni pi a square. This will be M only, capital M. So if we put it in the formula, we will get B is equals to mu naught upon 4 pi 2m upon x cube. Okay, so this is the magnetic field on the axis of a coil in the terms of magnetic moment. Okay, so SI unit of this magnetic moment is current into area, that means ampere meter square. Okay, so now if this is a magnetic, if we have a magnetic dipole moment, that means it must have two poles, north and south pole. The coil should have two poles. So how to know the poles? For that, look here, polarity of magnetic dipole. If in a coil, you see the current in clockwise direction, then that side will have south polarity. And if you see the current in clockwise, anti-clockwise direction, then that side will have north polarity. So therefore, we'll be having two poles as well in the coil, because when you will look from upward, for example, see this, if you will look from upward, you can see this is clockwise direction. Now if you see this same direction from downward, you will see it to be anti-clockwise. So we can say upper side has south pole, lower side has north pole. So therefore it is a dipole only. Okay, magnetic dipole. Okay, so remember this. And how can you remember this? If you draw a S, just draw arrows on its side. So now for this arrow is going like this, so in this direction current will be like this. For this, the arrow is like this, the current will be like this. Similarly, draw N and draw the arrows on its ends. The current, the arrow is like this, current will be like this in this direction. In this arrow is like this, current will be like this in this direction. So remember this thing. Okay, so now if I draw a graph between B and X, okay, so what will be, so for that see the formulas. At the center, when x was 0, we got the formula mu naught upon 4 pi I by a into 2n pi, which is a constant value. Okay, so therefore it will have some constant value. Okay, when we increase our x, as x goes in decreasing, as you can see, b is coming inversely proportional to x every time, so it will go on decreasing, and similarly for negative side. So this will be the graph for b and x. Okay, and one more thing. Remember, SI unit of magnetic field is Tesla. Okay, so the next topic is Ampere's circuital law. So basically, this law states that the total line integral of magnetic field around any closed loop is equal to mu naught times the total current threading the closed loop. That is, line integral of magnetic field around any closed loop. Okay, so line integral means integration of B with dl, line integral B dot dl. around any closed loop. This circle on the integration is implying the closed loop. Whenever we make a circle on the integration sign, that means we are talking about closed loop. Okay, so line integral of magnetic field for any closed loop is equals to mu naught times the total current threading the closed loop, that is B dot dl is equal to mu naught I. Okay, so mu naught is the absolute permeability of free space. And what do you mean by the current threading the closed loop? For that, look here, suppose there is a loop. Okay, if the total current crossing through it threads is I1, I2 and I3. So what will be the total current threading towards it, from it? That will be I1 plus I2 plus I3. So total I will be I1 plus I2 plus I3. So in this case, integration of B dot dl will be equal to mu naught I1 plus I2 plus I3. Okay, so this we mean by threading. Okay, so now we'll be doing its proof. Okay, so for the proof of Ampere's circuital law, let us suppose a conductor XY in which current I is flowing, and let us suppose an arbitrary loop. Okay, so now let us suppose that this arbitrary loop is made by these small displacements A, B and C, and let these loop, these small displacements are cutting angle d theta 1, d theta 2 and d theta 3 respectively. Okay, so now can you tell what will be the total sum of all the angles subtended? 2 pi, because obviously you know the total sum of angles for a circle is 2 pi at the center. So this, the sum of all these angles will be 2 pi. Now let us denote A by dl1, B by dl2, C by dl3 and so on. Okay, so now you know the formula theta is equal to arc upon radius. By using that formula, I am writing d theta 1 to be dl1 upon r1. D theta 2 as dl2 upon r2 and so on. Okay, so now if you look clearly for A point, let's say magnetic field for due to this element only is B1. Now you know the formula for a point for infinitely long wire of magnetic field, that is mu naught upon 4 pi 2 I by r. Okay, and one more thing, let us suppose the distance for this A displacement is R1. So for that, formula will be mu naught upon 4 pi 2 I by R1. Similarly for B, the magnitude, the formula of magnetic field will be mu naught upon 4 pi 2 I by R2 and so on. Okay, so now if I calculate total magnetic field or total line integral of magnetic field. So if I am writing B dot dl for total, it will be equal to B1 dl1 plus B2 dl2 and so on. So putting the values of B1 as mu naught upon 4 pi 2 I by R1 dl1, B2 is mu naught upon 4 pi 2 I by R2 dl2 and so on. Okay, so now if I take common mu naught upon 4 pi 2 I from that equation, it will be left by dl by R1 plus dl2 by R2 and so on. Okay, so now abhi humne likha hai dl by r, that is arc upon radius, that is angle only, so that means d theta 1 plus d theta 2 and so on, and sum of all the angles is 2 pi. Okay, so now by this you will get b dot dl is equal to mu naught upon mu naught I, because 4 pi will cancel out. Okay, so this is the proof of Ampere's circuital law, that b dot dl is equal to mu naught I. Okay, so now we'll be discussing the applications of Ampere's circuital law. So the first application is magnetic field due to an infinitely long straight wire. Before that, one more thing, always remember when you will do the integration of this dl, we will choose a loop. I'll be telling you in further applications, we will be choosing a loop. The integration of dl will be done for that loop only. Okay, it will be done for that loop only which we will be choosing, and that loop is called Ampere's loop. Okay, so let us start with the applications. Magnetic field due to an infinitely long straight wire carrying current. Okay, so let us suppose there is an infinitely long straight wire which is carrying current I. Okay, now to calculate magnetic field due to this at a point R, what we will do, we will choose a empirical loop. So we have chosen this as empirical loop. Okay, so now integration of dl will be done for this loop. Okay, so we want to calculate at P. So at this point, as we in Gaussian law, we draw a Gaussian surface where we want to calculate electric field. Similarly here, where we want to calculate magnetic field, we will draw an empirical loop at that surface. Okay, so now, can you tell the direction of B and dl at point P? As you know, dl is in the same direction of current. So it will be like this only, in the same direction of current. And B, as I told you in the last lecture, put your thumb in the direction of current and curl towards the point. So you will get magnetic field in this direction. Your curl will come to be in this direction only. Okay. So from here we can say B and DL both are in same direction. Okay. So now use empirical formula. B dot DL is equal to mu naught I by Ampere's law. So angle between them is 0. So B DL cos 0 will be mu naught I, cos 0 will be 1. Okay, so now as R on this loop, we are considering B to be constant. It will remain constant. So we'll take it out of integration of DL mu naught I. Now what will be integration of DL? That is done on the empirical loop, as I told you. So integration of DL will be 2 pi R, the circumference of this loop. B 2 pi R is equal to mu naught I. So B will be mu naught I upon 2 pi R. Or you can write it as mu naught upon 4 pi 2 I by R. Okay, so this is the same as we were using in the previous methods, and we have derived this by using Biot-Savart law as well. Okay, so the answer will be same, and by using Ampere's circuit law, it is much more important and it is much more easier to calculate it by this law. Okay, so now you can see if I take many loops of this size, a cylinder will be formed. We can say ki this wire has a cylindrical symmetry. Okay, so the wire has cylindrical symmetry. Okay, because when you will make many loops of this type, you will form a cylinder. Okay. Okay, students, so now I will be discussing the homework solutions of lecture number 1 from your chapter 4, and in total 5 questions were given to you. First 4 questions are of similar type, so I will be discussing question number 3rd from those 4 questions. So question number 3rd says that we have a wire which lies from north to south and it carries a current in north to south direction. We have to calculate magnetic field due to this wire at a point P which is lying towards east at a distance of 2.5 meters. Okay. So to calculate the magnitude of the magnetic field, you can use the formula directly, which is mu naught upon 4 pi 2 I by R, as we have calculated. So the formula will be 4 into 10 to the power minus 6 Tesla by putting the values. Okay. Now how to calculate the direction? Beta, you already know you can calculate the direction by using right hand thumb rule. So if I use right hand thumb rule, DL is in the same direction of current, that is this, and R is in this direction. So if you use DL cross R cap, your thumb will point upwards and you can say the magnetic field will be in upward direction. If someone has problem in the right hand thumb rule, then you can do this theoretically as well, like here. Okay, so what you have to do for that, take it as x axis, y axis, and this perpendicular axis as z axis. Okay, so if you will compare now, you can say I is in minus j cap direction, I is in minus j cap. You can say R is in I cap direction, R is in I cap. So now how to calculate B by its direction by DL cross R cap? So just put the values DL minus J cap cross I cap. Now you know J cross I is minus K. Minus minus will become positive, so it will K cap. And we have considered Z direction to be this. So that means K cap means positive upward direction. Okay. So from here also the direction will come to be same, that is upwards. Okay. So the next question is question number 14. So in question number 14, you are given two loops which are concentric. Okay, so first loop is x, second one is y. The radius of x and y are given. The number of turns in them is given and the current flowing through them is also given. Okay, and it is also given that when we stand while facing towards west, the current in x is seen to be in anti-clockwise direction and current in y is seen to be in clockwise direction. Okay, so we want to calculate magnetic field at the center of these two concentric loops. Okay, so first of all, what we'll do, we'll calculate the magnetic field due to them individually. So you know the formula of magnetic field at the center of a loop. So we'll be using that mu naught upon 4 pi 2 n pi I upon R. So by using the terms of x, you will get the value of magnetic field for x, and for same you will get it for y. Okay. Now how to calculate net magnetic field? To know the net magnetic field, we have to see the direction of magnetic field for both of them. So use your right hand thumb rule. If you will use your right hand thumb rule in x coil, the magnetic field is in anti-clockwise direction. So anti-clockwise means for it magnetic field will be in east side, and similarly for y it will be in west side. Okay, so you can say for x it will be towards east and for y it will be towards west. Okay. So as they are facing in opposite directions, so how to calculate negative? Just sorry, how to calculate a resultant? Just subtract them. So we'll be just subtracting them. So I am subtracting from y from x. So that means I am taking x direction as positive. So my answer will come in towards east. If you are subtracting x from y, that is by minus bx, then your answer will come towards west. Okay. So now as you can see here, negative sign is coming. Negative sign is coming towards east. So that means net magnetic field will be towards west only. Okay. Okay, for today's homework, do question number 16. Thank you.